If you're in the market for a new fifth wheel, there are a ton of options out there. Let's add one more, the brand new Brinkley Model Z. With its automotive exterior styling and residential interior styling, it really stands out in a crowd. Let's take a quick look, then I'll show you what sets this apart from a crowded pack. The RV industry is dominated with swooshy, swirly designs, which people really like, but Brinkley's gone to more of an automotive look with very clean lines and a very simple, understated look. Now, most luxury fifth wheels are gonna have frameless windows. This is a new style, it's called the Euro window, and there's one big difference I'll show you on the inside. Now, when it comes to quality, the devil's in the details. One thing I really like that's a small thing is these decals are actually like a raised gel. A lot of times you'll just see stickers that'll wear out over time. This seems like it would last a lot longer. Below there, you've got exterior storage. And if you look at this plating down here, this is not just your cheap plating. This is much higher in material. And you also have these motion sensor lights to light up all your bays. Here in the utility area, they went with a Furion tankless hot water system. And here in the wet bay, this is kind of interesting. You have the typical Nautilus system, but if you look up here, you actually have electric night valves for your gray tank and your black tank. You don't see that too often. One other thing you don't see too often is a retractable garden hose. This is actually 65 feet long, so it's one less thing you have to carry in your pass-through. As far as energy, you do have a 30-pound propane bottle over here and another one to match on the other side. You have plenty to get you through a weekend or even an extended stay. For exterior storage, it adds up to 130 cubic feet. Over here, you do have an outside shower, which is gonna work great to clean off your steps. It will come through this port here. And you also have LED strip lighting right up there, looks great. Here at the entrance door, check this out. You do have a punch pad, something you'd see on a diesel pusher generally. When you open up the door, we have the Moride solid steps. Now, if you've used these before, typically they're quite big, but these ones have a new feature where they'll flip down. That way, when you put them away and there's dirt and whatnot on the steps, you can just knock it all off. You don't have to sweep it. Then, over here, this is really cool. I haven't seen this before. This telescoping grab handle, this is all powder-coated seal. It's called a safety rail from Moride. Okay, let's get to the part you really came for. Let's take a look at the inside. Now, a lot of fifth wheels are going towards digital touchpads for these types of things with phone apps, but Brinkley made the decision to just go with redundant buttons. I mean, it's nice to have a touchscreen, but something like this, it's just very simple. Here in the kitchen, you do have a coffee bar, which a lot of people really like. These are solid surface countertops, and this isn't a peel and stick tile. That's actually a subway tile. If you take a look at this outlet, one thing that's really cool I haven't seen too often is you have the 110 outlets, but you also, if you come in close, have USBs and USB-Cs built right in. This pantry is massive. You have LED strip lights all the way up, and these shelves, if you take a close look, are actually adjustable, so you can set it for whatever height to make it work. And if you come down a little bit, right here, they actually put 110 outlets in there, so you could put your coffee maker or appliances in here permanently. This Furion fridge is great. It's a lot more residential than a lot of things that you see in a fifth wheel. So you have your fridge on this side, your freezer on this side. I mean, you could have an extended stay, no problem with something like this. I actually love this kitchen. You've got lots of counter space on the right, lots of counter space on the left, the three burner gas range, and a propane oven. You also have a large Furion microwave. Now, you also have lots of storage up above, lots of storage down below. These drawers are well constructed. And right here, you've even got, if you take a close look, a built-in spice rack. Over here, we've got a big island, lots of prep space on either side. And these gold fixtures, I don't know, they just look great. I know my wife would love it. Down in the sink, you've got a one-piece deep bowl sink and a drying rack to go over top. Coming down here, you actually have garbage and recycling and a pull-out paper towel holder with the Brinkley logo and a bit more storage here. Here in the entertainment area, we actually have a 50-inch pop-up TV on a televator. Down below, we've got a 5,000 BTU fireplace to keep you nice and toasty. Some storage below, and if you look at this shelf here, you actually have HDMIs, so you could put a Blu-ray player or an Apple TV or any kind of streaming device. Then up above, you have these nice cabinets with soft close and more of those gold fixtures. This sofa feels more at place in a nice apartment than it does in an RV. Very comfortable. And on the side, these custom-made end tables actually have hidden storage with a nice little shock. And back here, hidden USBs and 110 outlets. Oh man, these theater seats are nice and comfy. The color is great. They recline, and check this out. You got a wireless charger right here. Over here, we got the four-seater dinette. We do have a bench seat here and hidden cutlery storage. I actually have these same chairs in blue in my kitchen. They're very nice. Like I said, very residential on the inside. This back piece comes off. It's just magnets, not Velcro. And then this bench actually comes out to make a coffee table. Honestly, I've never seen a coffee table at the sofa. This is a great dual purpose. Oh yeah, it also can be an ottoman. Before we go upstairs, I want to show you the slide floor. If you take a look down here, they're totally flush. You'd have to look really close to notice that there's even a slide out. And if you come down this way, right over here, this kitchen, almost every fifth wheel I've seen, has about a 2-inch step right here. They've managed to get the floor completely flush. Again, going for a real residential look. Oh yeah, we can't forget the pets. Look at this. They put in a pet dish holder with these expandable water and food dishes. They're trying to think of everything, guys. Before we go upstairs, I want to point out a few small things I really like. First of all, this face trim, you won't see any nail holes or any kind of filler because it's actually screwed in from the back. A lot of times you'll see a little bit of filler and it just doesn't look quite right. Come over here. These windows we talked about outside actually have built-in blackouts as opposed to pleated shades or roller shades, and built-in bug screens. They also open all the way out, so you can actually keep those open during the rain. Now, every fifth wheeler is gonna find the bathroom to be very important. Let's take a look at the seat. It is porcelain. I got plenty of arm space, and back here, you actually have a portable teepee holder with room for extra rolls. It actually secures with a magnet, and believe it or not, it's powder coated. Over here in the vanity, you've got a decent sized sink for washing up, medicine cabinet for all your toiletries, three drawers, and some storage underneath. In the shower, you've got lots of space. Even a bigger person can get around, turn around. You've got lots of height. And look at this shower feature. You've got this nice sprayer, body sprayer, and a magic wand. I mean, it's got it all, just like a house. And finally, we're in the bedroom. Up top, you've got a nice size Insignia TV so you can watch TV while you're in bed. You have another window here with the bug screens and the blackouts. On top of the dresser, you've got some hidden storage for some valuables. Down below, you've got three drawers here and four below, all soft close as well. Coming over to the closet, if you're in a fifth wheel of this magnitude, you gotta have washer dryer prep and a little extra storage. In the main closet, you've got this beautiful glass finish, and watch when I open the door. You have this motion sensor track light that runs along the hang bar, and honestly, just a really good size. Finally, probably the most important part is the bed. This is not an RV mattress. This is a full memory foam mattress. I actually love this bed. I could use this one at home. Oh yeah, and one more thing. Underneath the bed, you've got strut assist to access your storage, 110 outlets, USB, USB-C on either side, and below, motion sensor lighting for when you get up to go to the washroom. Take a look at this. Look at those heat registers. That's residential quality. That's all for now. There are tons of features that I missed. Be sure to let us know if you'd like to come see one in person. We can dig into the details. From all of us here at Traveland RV in Airdrie, have a great day and happy camping.